Microsoft Defender for Office 365 helps you to efficiently detect and respond to user compromise. To demonstrate that, I'll walk through a scenario in which a user has issues, likely compromised credentials. My investigation starts with alerts about a user who is restricted from sending email. I've seen this before because the company is not using multi-factor authentication. The user restricted from sending email alert triggers when users have sent enough spam, phish, or malware messages to external recipients that it looks like they're malicious and potentially compromised. Affected users can receive but not send mail. Not only does this protect users, but it also protects the organization from getting a bad email reputation. This specific alert shows a high volume of suspicious emails. For lower volumes, we trigger suspicious sending alerts that have a temporary restriction. In this case, however, the user is locked out, so I need to investigate further to understand and clean up the problem. Looking at the investigation, which the alert automatically triggers, is my first step. Right off the bat, I can see in the investigation graph that Microsoft Defender for Office 365 found a couple of things. There's some phish, some malware, and spam. Threats include a malicious URL click. Digging into the findings, I see an email sent from the user to a person outside the organization. The system detected nothing as the email went out, but the recipient's organization blocked it. I also see that the user has sent numerous emails like the last one, mostly about reservations. However, the company sells products and has nothing to do with reservations. So, that's suspicious. To help expand my investigation, Microsoft Defender for Office 365 looked up other unrelated emails the user sent, and that'll help to find additional malicious email. First, because the system doesn't analyze outbound email for spam, I don't expect to see much here. In this one case, the email was blocked as it went into the other organization. However, looking at details about the clean emails the user sent, I see a lot of messages that do look like spam. The user has also been sending a good bit of malicious email to external recipients. Looking at those details, the system blocked most of them as they were outbound. Not only do I need to clean up these problems, but I also need to check whether any of this is associated with the listed URL, because it looks like somebody clicked it. Over on the Entities tab, I'm first going to find the infected user. In this case, that person is Polly Harrell, and there are numerous problems associated with her account. But for now, I'm interested in the URL she was sending. And looking at its details, I see blocked emails associated with it, so it's unlikely to be anything good. Opening an email containing the URL, I see the bad URL. Delivery failed, so it wasn't getting outside, and I don't have to worry anybody else about it. That's good. But when I go look at the clicks, I can see a bunch of allowed clicks, some blocked clicks, and some block overridden clicks. Someone was doing something they shouldn't. Below the chart is a list of clicks. I can see the system initially treated the URL as good. However, after identifying the URL as bad, the system blocked it and triggered the alert. It looks like Polly clicked this URL, got infected, and started sending spam and malicious email. The list identifies other users as well, and I'll have to look closer at each later. On the Users tab, I see that Polly clicked a malicious URL and sent malware and phish. There's also a suspicious inbox rule. Looking at the details gives me insight into the things she's been sending. It also gives me a chance to look more at the evidence. In this case, she was sending malicious emails, and if needed, I can click over to Explorer or look closer at the raw data. At the end of the day, I need to act to clean up this mess. So, the Actions tab shows all the actions I can approve that are associated with this user and the problem. The first is to force a password reset on Polly's account. There's also actions to clean up emails inside the organization related to this problem. The last is to disable suspicious inbox rules, so the account no longer sends emails outside the organization. The attacker is likely using these to gain persistence for the user. Of course, I'm going to approve all the actions and provide my explanation. After confirming my approval, Microsoft Defender for Office 365 will log my approvals and start cleaning up. The last thing I need to do is unblock the user account. To do that, on the Original Alerts Details side pane, select View Restricted User Details. The Restrictions panel shows information about what's going on, which was also in the alert, plus several recommendations. We've completed these as part of the investigation and already reset the account. I've also had a chat with Polly about thoughtlessly clicking links. So, I'm going to unblock the user account now, and Polly can once again send email. In Microsoft Defender for Office 365, you can efficiently detect and respond to user compromise. For more information, see our documentation on Microsoft Docs.